We've been telling people for years, boy, this thing's going to be improved. It's a game changer. It's orders of magnitude improved with different attributes. But of course, when seeing those first images and seeing not just satellite meteorologists, but meteorologists, non-meteorologists, just being so excited about it, now they realize how big of a step improvement it really is.
Once the satellite got into orbit, have there been any challenges, any operational challenges, any difficulties or surprises?
No, I mean, you know, it's a long way from being operational. As you said, we just took our first light images that were just released yesterday. And, you know, when I've looked at the images, they kind of look what I expected. We had some glimpse either computer simulations before or other satellites, so we had an idea what it should look like. And I've been pleasantly surprised because it has been what we've been saying, improved and improved and improved. There certainly be some non-operational data sooner during its extended validation period checkout.
What about the instruments measuring space weather and solar activity? Are those all working?
Yep, those are all. So there are six total instruments, four dealing, like you say, with space weather in some way, the space environment or the sun. Two Earth viewing instruments, the geostationary lightning mapper, which gives you total lightning using an optical scanner, and then this advanced baseline imager, or ABI, which is the next generation imager. All instruments have sent down data and all are working through their engineering checkouts before they're deemed beta and move forward.